right from my childhood. I have made many trips to many places, wild and wonderful places. But I have to say that Kailash, in terms of its possibility,immensity of what it is, so I have never seen anything like that till now. If there is some physical form in this existence that could be nearest to what we refer to as Shiva, this is it.When people set off on pilgrimages in the past in India, a pilgrimage means the entire village or the town worship that man who is living because he is taking a step from which there may be no turning back. When they go on a pilgrimage, there was not even an intention of coming back. If they come back, it was considered a miracle because...Without any kind of modern amenities, I want you to imagine yourself going through these mountains without your down jackets, your hi-fi boots and so many things, barefoot, walking maybe with a woolen rug. It would be a different game altogether, completely different game. Nobody believed that they will come back, but still people went, not one or two, thousands of them. But Kailash,In the last 12,000-year history, there is a 12,000-year history that every year, without a single year's break, pilgrims from India have been going to Kailash walking, 12,000 years. Even in the most severe weather some years, in spite of that, there has not been a break. The stream of pilgrims have been coming. This year there was a threat, but... It's kind of cleared up now. So, for these pilgrims, I want you to imagine from Chennai or Coimbatore you set off walking to Kailash. You don't have a map, you don't have a GPS, nobody to tell you exactly where it is, but you're going. I want you to understand what kind of fire should be burning in their heart. What kind of fire should be burning in a man's heart to leave everything that he knows, all the comforts, everything that matters to him and go away somewhere, not knowing whether he will come back or not? It doesn't matter. Today we have conveniences, we have comforts, but don't miss the significance. I want you to walk like how they walked 1,000 years ago. With what kind of fire they must have walked, putting their life at stake.Putting everything that they valued in their life at stake, okay? Not knowing what will happen to them, just going. When people went about chanting Shiva and walked from the southern tip of India to somewhere here, they were not trying to follow a religion. There was no religion for them. They were religionless people. They had no distinction between, oh, this is my kind of belief versus your kind of belief. They just saw...the sound as a tool to hang on to. If you use the tool effectively, it'll do wonders to you. They never saw it as a religion. It's only later on, when competition came, the entire thing got projected as yours versus mine. There was no such thing. India is a religionless land. There never was a religion, okay? Spiritual process means this.It's not about how you look for somebody, how you are within yourself, because this is the quality of your life. If you sit here, how beautiful a life are you within yourself? Nobody can see this. Nobody need to clap their hands for this. Nobody need to give you a prize for this. Nobody need to give you a job for this. Nobody is going to even pay attention to this. But this is worthwhile, that you are a beautiful life. It is truly worthwhile that if you sit here, you are a beautiful life within yourself. This is the most worthwhile thing. If this doesn't happen, How will you ever taste life? All that's happening is just psychological drama of your own thoughts and emotions endlessly. To make this happen for yourself, you must walk with the same spirit and fire as the pilgrims, right from ancient times have done. Then you will know something, which is not just the colors of life, but that which is the basis of life.
When you take to Kailash, from the place where you walk, it's literally like you're walking on the body of Shiva. Being of his proportions, in many ways, has laid himself down to be walked upon.
Why Kailash is held as the abode of Shiva is not because he's sitting on top of the mountain, because everything that he knew, he stored in this mountain. What that mountain represents and what it is capable of is so immense. Your ability to make use of it, I don't believe you can. It takes a lot of knowledge and capability. But you cannot miss the immensity of it. Nobody can miss the immensity of it if they go with the right sense of openness in them. You don't have to believe anything. Belief will only disturb things. Belief will lead to imagination. But staying open, what it means is unprejudiced mind. Unprejudiced mind means from here on, you should not identify with anything. Simply, you must go.
Thank you.